Well, hello and welcome to our midweek worship for this week. It was supposed to be from Rawcliffe, but with the motorway bridge being closed and the utter traffic chaos last night, it wasn't really very easy to get to Rawcliffe in order to lead a service there. So what I'm doing is recording it from home this week, and hopefully as the traffic settles, as we get used to having only one lane going eastbound on the motorway, that things will be easier to get there and back, and we'll start operating normally again. So today the service comes from here, and I hope it's really helpful to you. Welcome to our church, to what we want to be, a family of love. Welcome to familiar faces. Welcome to first timers. Welcome to the old and the young and the somewhere in betweens. Welcome to a place of warm friendship, acceptance and fun. Welcome to a space for silence and solitude. Welcome to a place of joy and laughter. Welcome to an encounter with the unchanging, abundant, steadfast love of God. His generous banquet is lovingly prepared with you in mind. Welcome to the silly and the serious, the honest and the pretending, the lonely and the crowded. Welcome to those who need to be held and those who need to be released. Welcome as you are, a precious part of God's family. Welcome to our church. Come if you're healthy. Come if you're hurt. Come if you're hopeful. Come if you're sad. Let God's light shine upon you. Let God's life fill you. Let God bring you healing and hope today. God of light and life, you see all our problems and our pains. Help us to open our hearts and minds to you, to receive your healing and forgiveness, and to learn how we can bring hope and healing to others. Amen. Our first song today is this song, Come All You Who Are Thirsty. Some of you will know it, some of you won't, but this is an opportunity to learn it for the new ones and to sing it for those who aren't used to it. We have Come All You Who Are Thirsty.
Come to the world.
So we have a Bible reading from Revelation chapter 21. John says, "So he took me in the spirit to a great high mountain, and he showed me the holy city Jerusalem descending out of heaven from God. I saw no temple in the city, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are its temple. And the city has no need of sun or moon, for the glory of God illuminates the city, and the Lamb is its light. The nations will walk in its light, and the kings of the world will enter the city in all their glory. Its gates will never be closed at the end of the day, because there is no night there. And all the nations will bring their glory and honour into the city. Nothing evil will be allowed to enter, nor anyone who practices shameful idolatry and dishonesty, but only those whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Then the angel showed me a river with the water of life, clear as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb. It flowed down the centre of the main street. On each side of the river grew a tree of life, bearing 12 crops of fruit, with a fresh crop each month. The leaves were used for medicine to heal the nations. No longer will there be a curse upon anything, for the throne of God and of the Lamb will be there, and his servants will worship him, and they will see his face, and his name will be written on their foreheads. And there will be no night there, no need for lamps or sun, for the Lord God will shine on them, and they will reign for ever and ever." That story from, well, vision from Revelation that John has, that he writes down and encourages us to understand something of what heaven might be like, is one that can be of great encouragement and a great source of help to us, in hope that one day things will be better. I used to kind of hang on for that Bob Dylan idea. Well, it's in one of his songs, that one day everything will be all right when I paint my masterpiece. And I used to think that if I worked and worked to try and get things in the right place, then eventually things will be right. And sometimes we can be like that about heaven. We can think that this earth is an awful place and there are so many troubles here that we cannot overcome, and that we just need to look forward to heaven and to eventual healing there. But Christian belief doesn't allow us to do that. It asks us to look to heaven, where eventually everything will be sorted, but to start moving into the kingdom of heaven now, to start existing within that structure and within that gifted world that God is giving to us at the end of time, and start to be part of that now. And so when we hear these pictures and see these, or hear these stories and see these pictures of what heaven is like, we are to begin to see a faint shadow, a beginning of some view over the horizon into heaven appearing in our lives, and to see these things beginning to happen. And so the healing of the nations is something that we can and should be looking for now. The healing of our hearts and our minds, the power of God to provide for all of our needs. These things are things that we begin to seek now, not just at the end of time. And the turning away from evil and the putting of evil to a side within the kingdom of God, and no longer allowing those kind of things which won't be allowed in heaven to continue in our own community of love that God is drawing us into. And these things we need to hold on to and grasp, because they enable us to begin to move towards that which is to come. Of course, our dimly painted sketch of what things will be like is only a foretaste, a vague hors d'oeuvre, but it is nevertheless something that should be real. And we should build into it that expectation of something greater to come. We shouldn't gorge ourselves on the hors d'oeuvre, but use it as an hors d'oeuvre in order that we might be ready for that which is to come. And where there is this need to try and persuade others that they have this opportunity, this golden opportunity to put their trust in God, to turn away from all that destroys life and to find all that will enhance life now and into eternity, we are to work to enable them to do that. For otherwise, as this story tells us, they will come to the end of time and they will not be welcomed to a place where those who choose wrong over right are allowed in, and those who have, I think I got that wrong, those who choose wrong over right are not allowed in, and only those who have chosen to put their trust in the one who makes us right and righteous is possible. So we look to these pictures as a way to help us both in the now and for the future, and to challenge us to reach out to others. And we pray that God may help us, because these things are not always easy. Amen. So as we reflect, we're going to have another song which helps us to reflect on all sorts of things that we are both seeing change now and hoping will change in the heavenlies. We listen to Longing for Light, or sing along to it.
Shine.
So we know that we haven't really matched up to what God would want, and we come to our time of confession. When the Lord comes, he will bring to light the things now hidden in and will disclose the purpose of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us admit our failures and weaknesses. Lord, you give us life, but there are times when we don't live life the way you wish us to. When pain has us in its grip, we may give in to the gloom of pessimism. Forgive us when we see only the gloomy downside of situations. Forgive us when circumstances take over and moaning is easier than fighting. Dark times sap our strength and courage and blind us to your light. Renew our strength to fight our way into your healing light. Amen. Through the gift of Jesus' life, we are forgiven and cleansed. Let us praise God for his Son, our Saviour, who through the cross paid the price for our wrongdoing. So be it. Amen. Nothing is hidden from you, Lord. Thank you for your light shining into the darkest corners. Taking a walk in the park or on the beach is a healing balm to a troubled mind. Calling someone to see how they are offers the comfort and reassurance of a friendly voice. Baking a cake to welcome new neighbours is an act of kindness that feeds a hunger for acceptance. Helping someone with their garden or carrying their shopping shows the caring touch and lightness and lightens the load of loneliness. Thank you for the hope and healing you bring about in our life and our world. Thank you for guiding and using us to bring your light to others. One day there will be no more darkness, no more pain or disappointment. All people and nations will be healed and renewed. We thank you, Lord, for your promise that all will be well. Amen. And we pray for our world. Over the huge boundaries between rich and poor, we pray equality. Over the powerful boundaries between justice and oppression, we pray truth. Over the cultural boundaries between church and community, we pray connections. Over any bitter boundaries between families, we pray reconciliation. Over all the boundaries that divide, we pray trust and openness and new beginnings in Jesus' name. Amen. We join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Dad in heaven above, let everyone look up to you and the area where you are in charge grow. May what you want happen on earth as perfectly as it does in heaven. Please give to us what we need for today. Forgive us when we think or do wrong things, just as we don't hold it against those who hurt us. Guide us away from whatever we might want, but is unhelpful to us, and protect us from all that is nasty and destructive. For you are in charge of everything. You have the power to do it, and you are awesome. You always were, you are now, and always will be. Amen. Our final song today is an old song, And Now the Green Blade Riseth.
The green blade rises.
So we pray this prayer together. Glorious God, you shine your light into the dark places of our lives and of our world. Gentle God, you touch us with your healing love and make us whole. We ask you to be with us and shine through us this week, and use us to bring hope and healing to others. Amen. May your hearts then be at peace and your mind be at rest. May you be confident in who you are and share God's gifts of light, hope and grace with those you meet and those you pray for. And may the blessing of God fill your hearts with hope this day and evermore. Amen.